Solving equations by factoring. GCFs as factors. When solving, do not forget that the GCF is a factor also. If there is no variable in the GCF, then we can ignore it. So let's take a look at our two examples here. In example one, we have 4x cubed minus 12x squared equal to 40x. So the first thing we want to do is get that 40x on the other side. We'll do that by subtracting 40x from both sides. I will write it in descending order. And let's see, we've got 4, 12, and 40. It looks like they have a common factor of 4. And they all have x's, so x is a common factor also. So 4 divided by 4 is 1. X cubed divided by x is x squared. 12 divided by 4 is 3, and x squared divided by x is x. 40 divided by 4 is 10. And x divided by x is 1. Okay, now we need to factor our trinomial part, so I'll set my two sets of parentheses. I need to put my x's in for free. And the factors of 10 that when I take the difference give me 3 is 2 and 5. We want a negative 3, so my 5 will be negative, my 2 will be positive. Now that I have it factored, I set each one of those equal to 0. So I have 4x equal to 0, x minus 5 equal to 0, and x plus 2 equal to 0. Solving the first one, we'll divide by 4, we get x equal to 0. Solving the second one, I'll add 5 to both sides, and I get x is equal to 5. Solving the third one, I subtract 2 from both sides, I get x equal to 2. We had an exponent of 3, so I have 3 answers, x equal to 0, x equal to 5, and x equal to 2. Taking a look at our second example, I need to move my 36 and 15 over, so I'm going to subtract 36 and add 15x. So now I have, in descending order, 6x squared plus 15x minus 36 equal to 0. When I look at my numbers, 6, 15, and 36, I notice that I have a common factor of 3. So I'll pull out the 3. We don't have any variables in common. 6 divided by 3 is going to give me 2x squared. 15 divided by 3 is 5. And 36 divided by 3 is going to give me a 12. Because my 3 does not have a variable involved, I can ignore it. I can just cross it off. It's not going to have any bearing on my answer. So I'll put in my two sets of parentheses. Only one way of factoring 2x. And when I look at my 12, I think I'm going to go with 3 and 4 because if I use 6 and 2, they'll have common factors with 2. So we're going to avoid that. So I've got 8x minus 3x, which will give me 5x. My signs are right. So I've got a plus in my last set of parentheses and a negative in my first set. Now that I have that factored, I can set each one of those equal to 0. So I have 2x minus 3 equal to 0 and x plus 4 equal to 0. Add 3 to both sides. I get 2x equal to 3. Divide by 2. And I get x is equal to 3/2. For my other equation, I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides. And I'm going to get x is equal to negative 4. So my two solutions then are 3/2 and negative 4. Again, note that my highest exponent was 2. I have two solutions.